What is automation? Automation is technology that helps streamline a process or a procedure. It doesn't have to be computerized. It can be as simple as a thermostat that turns your heat on and off for you. Automation terminology can be confusing, so let's break it down a little. Business process automation, BPA, is the use of technology to automate complex business processes, such as accounting, sales, or insurance claims. Robotics process automation, RPA, uses technology to automate business process management, like emailing a catalog link to someone when they make a payment, or putting together parts on an assembly line. When you add AI to automation, you get intelligent automation. So that thermostat doesn't just turn heat on and off, it learns when and how much, saving you time and money. Here's where the rubber literally hits the road. Using intelligent automation, the Ducati racing motorbike accesses data to track and continuously improve its performance. Race engineers view performance data on a mobile dashboard that allows them to experiment with different bike configurations and predict outcomes as they work with the rider in pre-race preparation. Automation for the win! What does intelligent automation do? A lot. Let's start with the basics. We automate processes, usually one of four kinds. First, business and industrial processes. At work, automation can handle routine tasks in areas like finance and accounting, knowledge management, and warehouse management. This lets you focus on more complex and important things like problem solving and strategic planning. Next, IT processes. Automation speeds up software development, software maintenance, and cloud migrations. Home processes. It can help you regulate the thermostat, turn your lights on and off, and keep your floors clean. If you have ever had a Roomba, you've used automation at home. And lastly, transportation processes. We're not just talking about self-driving cars or cruise control. If you've ever used an app to give you directions while you drive, you have used an automated transportation process. The warning lights that come on when it's time to change your oil or check your air pressure are also automation. If your car automatically brakes when it senses an object coming too close, that's automation too. What do we automate? Processes. When do we automate them? All the time. Why does automation matter? It matters because of the tremendous impact it has on our lives and our businesses. To succeed in this environment, people and businesses rely on automation to keep up the pace, simplify their tasks, keep them agile, and lower their costs. The benefits of automation are huge. At the organizational level, automation does many things. It streamlines the organization's processes and provides stable, reliable results. It helps us to understand customers, their preferences, and their behaviors. It drives innovation and improves strategic focus so that highly trained staff are freed from repetitive tasks and instead can devote their time to tasks that require empathy and advanced cognition. And on the process level, automation offers more measurable benefits. It reduces manual errors, shortens reporting time, and keeps the business compliant with laws and regulations. With automation, approvals come faster and the need for paper-based records disappears. The cycle time for processes speeds up significantly, saving lots of time and labor. These improvements in accuracy, efficiency, and speed can reduce the cost of transaction processing by up to 80%. Robotic process automation is relatively easy to implement, configure, and maintain. And perhaps most of all, automation improves service continuity during difficult times. We saw this clearly when the COVID-19 pandemic struck and the demand for medical products, PPE, and basic household products spiked. Companies that had a strong automation strategy in place were able to continue running critical business processes with minimal disruption while the rest of the world adjusted to the new reality. Automation was successfully used to maintain the supply chain for healthcare and food products, proving that logistics is the backbone of a functioning society. And that is why automation matters. how is automation applied? To apply intelligent automation intelligently, start with the people at the heart of the company. Learn about what they do and work with them to define what their processes would look like in an ideal world. Automation gives people a chance to really think about the best way to do things within the context of changes that need to occur in the organization. Then we begin what we call the OPERA approach. OPERA is a three-phase process. First, we optimize the manual processes so they really are being done in the best way. Then, we eradicate any inefficient or out-of-date manual processes. Then, and only then, do we automate the optimized processes.
Optimize! Eradicate! Automate!
When applying automation, think of a company in layers. Let's start at the outside with the customer-facing layer. Now we'll go a bit deeper and look at the business layer. All businesses have needs and requirements that need to be met. Going a bit further in, there's the application layer. Applications are software that run the processes that meet your business requirements. At the very core is the IT layer, where the technological infrastructure you need to run your applications sits. A business process usually affects all layers. So, if you want to automate a group of business processes effectively, you must drill through the layers to the core of the IT systems and existing processes for its implementation. To apply automation appropriately, you look at the business layer and identify bottlenecks in your existing processes and prioritize them. Then you can begin to implement the automation in the IT layer so that it will result in a smooth and efficient customer-facing layer. Augment the application layer with Digital Coworker, apps that sort business tasks and perform the simple ones. Then you make the best of your human talent. Now that they are freed from the repetitive, mundane tasks, they can focus on more imaginative, complex, and productive work. How does automation work? Quietly and behind the scenes. You probably run into the benefits of automation every day without even realizing it. Let's watch as Marco runs into it and a few other things. Oh, yikes! It looks like this is not Marco's day. Helen's insurer is automated, but Marco's is not. Let's see how quickly they each get things sorted after their accident. Both Marco and Helen have to tell their insurers basic details about the accident, when it happened, where it was, and who was involved. Helen takes a picture of his car with her phone and sends it to the company. Marco is not so lucky. He has to wait for a claims investigator to inspect his car. From the photos she submitted, the automated bot at Helen's insurer immediately starts evaluating and estimating the damage to her car using an advanced image analysis occupation. Marco is still waiting for the human investigator to get back to him about the damage to his car. The damage to Helen's car is assessed instantly and evaluated against set rules fed into the application. Poor Marco is still waiting at home for the investigator to come and look at his vehicle. When he finally does arrive, he spends an hour looking at his car and taking a ton of pictures before heading back to the office. Within minutes, Helen's simple claim is processed and complete, without a claims adjuster. Marco, however, is waiting to hear what his claims adjuster comes up with. Several days later, Marco gets a call from the insurance company approving his claim and offering him a specific dollar amount to pay for the damage to his car. Marco thinks it isn't enough and that the adjuster made a mistake. Helen receives her payment right away. Her entire process, from accident to payment, is half the time that it takes for Marco to get his payment. Marco still waits and spends even more time arguing with the insurance company about the proper settlement amount. Eventually, he accepts their offer, and a week or two later, a check is mailed to his house. Automation. It lets your bad times disappear faster. Does automation combine with other technologies? Indeed, it combines with almost all of them. Automation has changed the rules of the game, not just for businesses, but for the world. It touches nearly every single technology we discuss in TQ. Intelligent automation is data-driven, meaning it builds on top of data, specifically good data. Bad data leads to bad outcomes. Algorithms fueled by bad data produce, at best, inaccurate results and, at worst, biased and harmful outcomes. The right data puts the intelligence in intelligent automation. And of course, automation and artificial intelligence are so intertwined that we can't talk about one without the other. Automation is built on enterprise platforms, and development can be moved to the cloud. In fact, the cloud itself works better when it's automated. Applications for automation are developed using agile DevOps methods. And some agile and DevOps methods can be automated themselves. Automated processes require security, just like when they were done manually. Even the simplest robotics often handle sensitive information, such as account numbers and personal data. So you see, where you find automation, you will find other TQ technologies as well.